that announced game that we really have a chance to win on our side?
I definitely think it's worth doing, and I would say more. You can take the algorithm, but you can also take or require the decisions, the inputs, the data that was inputted, and the decisions that were outputted. And sometimes you can actually observe that, even if, I mean, sometimes that might give you a strong indication. So if the algorithm, they say that the algorithm does X, but you also have information on the kind of decisions that were made in practice, okay? Then you can actually test whether the algorithm that you got is the real algorithm or whether there's a cheating going on. So again, looking broader at these digital economy issues.
I have a question for Gail.
So when you think of policy,
when you think of policy, you always weigh cost and benefit.
But many of the policies have cost and benefits that could vary by country, from country to country. Say, just an extreme example, you decide to break up Facebook. Perhaps all the consumers around the world would benefit, but most of the cost would be in the U.S. if it loses market value. Most of the investors are Americans. Americans will lose their jobs. America will lose its soft power because maybe the new company that will compete against them will come from another country. So how do you balance that? Do you only appear within the cost and benefits that are specific to the U.S., or do you take like a wider view with the hope of getting some convergence with another country?
I hear that, and I think that's a powerful, important question. Fortunately, or for what it's worth, so in some sense, the question we face is a little easier, right? So our question, and I won't take you up on your invitation to discuss any individual company. We'll be discussing our inquiries writ large and not with respect to any individual company. Our inquiry is, does the conduct, the merger, the non-merger conduct, whatever, does it violate the antitrust laws, the American antitrust laws? That's the question we're asking. And I think that it's a powerful question, a difficult question. It involves, as I said at the beginning, rigorous attention to the actual facts of the case, and that's what we're going to be focusing on.